Here's another fun recurrence problem called lines in the plane, which is basically like how many slices of pizza can you get for making n straight cuts? Now you're probably thinking that's not hard because I'll just do like this and then I can get six, and now I've got eight and now I've got, you know, more, 10. All right, but that's not actually what we're looking at. The secret here, the catch, is they don't have to be equal. Which always reminds me of the story where this mom was talking about how she would like make her kids like pancake or a sandwich or something that required being cut in half. And then she would cut it in half and then the kids would argue over which half was the bigger one. So what she did is she put one kid in charge of cutting it and then the other kid in charge of picking which half they wanted. So like one kid, if they did a bad job of cutting it in half, the other one would grab the other side and then she never had to worry again. All right. So the idea is if I have a, I'm just gonna make my pizza square now. Square pizza. I could cut it once and I can cut it twice, but now if I want to cut it a third time, instead of going through the center, I could come through here and I actually get an extra spot. So instead of three slices making six cuts, I've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven cuts. Okay, so there's a fancy math way of saying this, and that is, what is the maximum number of regions L sub n defined by n lines in the plane? So whether you like to think of it as regions in a plane or slices, unequal slices of pizza, I would recommend to pause the video and figure out, I'm gonna draw five boxes and see how you can break them up. Okay, so for this one, I'll give you a hint. If I don't make any cuts, the number of regions is one. And if I make one cut, the number of, oh, I should say L, n sub 0 is 1, and n sub 1 is 2, because if I make one cut, it gets to be two slices. So, I'm going to play around. So, if I've got this cut here, I have two slices. So, take a minute, pause the video, and actually see if you can figure this out for n equals 2. I already gave you that one, actually. I actually gave you n equals 3 as well. And n equals 4, because that's where it starts to get a little funny. All right? So pause the video. Give that a shot. Okay, we'll pretend you did that. So what I have, the 1 and the 2 is relatively straightforward. So here's clearly one slice. One slice, two slices. Okay, so on the third one, there's really not a whole lot interesting. Actually, I'll make that one because it's a, I'm going to leave that pre-existing cut there, and then I can come in and I can make another one. Okay, so that's my new one, and I have the 1, the 2, the 3, and the 4. So L sub 2 is equal to 4. Again, not very, very shocking. Okay, so I'm going to keep those two cuts for this guy. So for the 3, I'm able to create a new cut. Let's call this cut right here. Okay. And now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So L sub 3 is 7. Then I'm going to keep the same cuts as before. Pachoo. Pachoo. And then I have this one here. And then I need to make one more. Actually, I need to fix this box a little bit for it to work. I scooched my little green line up a little bit and then make a new green line. So, yep, all right. So now what you should have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. All right, so if you didn't get 11, you did it wrong. Nothing else to say except for that. All right, so if you didn't get a line, you got it wrong. Okay, so you have to think about what we were doing. Okay, so here, if we go back to the n equals 1 guy, what we can think about is we split one region into two each. Okay, so we can say, well, what we did is we took the one region from here, this was one region, and we split one region into two each, so one times two, so we have two now, whereas before we only had one. So since we used to have one, now we have two. One times two is two. We used to have one, and we have two. We have one more. On the next one here, we can say, well, what we did is we took those two regions and we split two regions into two each. So let me do it this way because I'm running out of room. So here we added one, but here we added two because we had two. Now we have two times two is four. So we added two more. All right. Now looking at the next one, the math is going to be the same, but a little bit more specific. So for this one, we split three regions into two each, but that doesn't mean that it's three times two is six because there's still one region left over. That's this one that we didn't touch. That region was just left from here. This region number four that becomes region number seven stays unchanged. So it's three times two is six, then plus seven, which is where we get the seven. So we still increase the total number of sections or regions by three. So probably not shockingly, what we'll find is on n equals four, we're going to split four regions into two each. So that would have been, this here used to be a region like that. This one here used to be a region. This one here, used to be a region. And this one here was a region. So those four regions we split into two each. So that's four times two is eight, but we left three regions untouched, which gives us 11. And so that basically still just means that we added four more. Okay. So each time we draw a new line, if you kind of look at what we have now here, we have a plus one, plus two, plus three, and plus four. And this is honestly how math works. If you think that people who do math well are basically math geniuses, I mean, we'd like to think so, but honestly, it's just because we're lonely and we stare at stuff because we just can't stop thinking about it. So the idea is you kind of stare at this, you're like, oh my gosh, I see the pattern. Every time I draw a new line, I get one new region than I had before. So that means we can actually create a recursive algorithm or recursive formula. So what that means is every time we have a new line, we're going to have the same number of regions as we had before, except we're going to add n. Okay? Now, don't forget the base case. We need to give it L sub 0. So with 0 lines, we decided that we have one region. And our validity range is it works for n equals greater than, n is greater than or equal to 1. And we can say a is the set of positive integers. I guess probably I should write this up here. N is greater than or equal to 1. Or n is a positive integer. So, yay! So we do have a recursive formula that tells us what we're going to do. Now, the question is, can we turn this into a closed formula? And the way we're going to do this is we're going to start by just listing the values and see if we see a pattern, kind of like what we did if you watched the Towers of Hanoi video. All right, so those are the values. Do you see a pattern? I mean, aside from the fact that you just add n, but like if you were going to say f of n is equal to n squared plus 5, n plus 17 or something like that, like, no, I don't have a relationship between the 4 and the 11 or the 3 and the 7 or the 2 and the 4. I can't see it off the top of my head. So we're going to do a mathematical technique that you can call unwinding, unfolding, but I just kind of like to call messing around with it. So, and again, this is what you do when you're a grad student and you're kind of lonely, never really had a ton of friends and stuff like that. So basically what I'm doing is I'm going to take this definition, which I know is true, and everywhere I see an n, I'm going to put in an n minus 1, so that becomes n minus 1, n minus 2, and n minus 1, and I'm going to do that again, so I have n minus 2, n minus 3, plus n minus 2, and I'm just doing that to get the pattern kind of established in my head. So, go! All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to start off with n. I keep saying n. I should say L sub n. L sub n is equal to L sub n minus 1 plus n. Now, I know that L sub n minus 1 is equal to L sub n minus 2 plus n minus 1. let me make this a different color so you can kind of see it. So this is L sub n minus 2 plus n minus 1, and then the plus n stays there. All right, but I happen to know that L sub n minus 2 is something, so I can plug that in. So I'm going to plug that in as L sub n minus 3 plus n minus 2, and then I have the plus n minus 1, and then plus n. Okay, so maybe now you see the pattern is that I keep, as this number gets smaller, then we keep adding terms here, which maybe should make sense. But the idea is we're going to see the pattern is if we keep going down, the smallest number we could get to would be L sub n minus, because I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way up to L sub n minus n. And then that one would be matched with n minus. And if you look at the relationship between this number and this number, we subtract 1 from here to get that number, okay? So n minus 1 plus da-da-da-da-da-da-da plus n minus 2 plus n minus 1 plus n. Okay, so I think the biggest leap of faith here is just recognizing that this n minus this 3 comes down to a 2, so that this n would come to an n minus 1. Okay, so I've got L sub n is equal to L sub n minus n is obviously L minus or L sub 0, n minus, if I distribute that, I've got n minus n plus 1, which is equal to 1. There we go. All right. So plus 1 plus, so basically you can kind of see what's going to happen is it's going to go 1 plus 2 plus da 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 plus n, oh, I got to move this down, n minus 2 plus n minus 1 plus n. So basically it's going to be the starting point, which we happen to know is 1 because we established that. If I don't draw any lines, I have one region. So it's going to be 1 plus the numbers 1 to n, all added together. And he should be like, I feel like I should know this. And the answer is yes, you should know this. So there's a story about like some math kid, Gauss, and he was really obnoxious and was 8 years old. And his teacher was like, get out of my face because you're asking too many questions. So I want you to add up the numbers 1 to 100 or 1 to some giant number. And that's how he did it. He went 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way plus 97. I'll do 98. 99 and 100, and then he wrote them again, 100 plus 99 plus 98 plus all the way to 3 plus 2 plus 1. So if I call this my summation of the first 100 numbers, let's do it that way, then this is the summation of the first 100 numbers. So if I was going to add these together, I'd get twice the summation of the first 100 numbers is 101. Plus 101, plus 101, plus 101, plus 101, plus 101. And how many 101s do I have? I have 100 of them. So I can say that twice the sum of the numbers of 1 to 100 is 100 times 101. I can just do this like that. Okay, so really the formula is that the sum of the first n numbers is n times n plus 1 over 2. So if you can't ever remember the formula, it's pretty easy to rederive. So Gauss kind of gets the funny story for doing it when he was like 8 years old, but Archimedes actually discovered it like 2,000 years before. So, but it's still kind of a big deal if you're 8. I mean, you like learn to tie your shoes and you're still proud even though someone else knew how to do it before you did. So anyway, the point being that for all of this right here, I can substitute n times n plus 1 over 2. Yay! So I've got L sub n is equal to 1 plus n times n plus 1 over 2. Huh, awesome. Now if you really, really, really want to do this with proof by induction, we can do that. We've covered proof by induction in another video, but basically the idea is you want to prove for a base case. So again, we want to say that if we're going to prove it for a base case and then establish that if we assume that it works for k, then it has to work for k plus 1. Okay. So for the base case. L sub 0 is that equal to 1 plus 0 times 0 plus 1 over 2. And let's see, this is so tantalizing. Yes, L sub 0 is equal to 1. Yay, I established for the base case. Now we're going to assume that it does in fact work for k. 1 plus k times k plus 1 over 2. And then our goal is to show that L sub k plus 1 is equal to 1 plus k plus 1, and then k plus 1 plus 1 over 2. So everywhere I see a k, I put in a k plus 1, so that's our goal. Yay! All right, so we know, because we showed it earlier, that L sub k is equal to L sub k plus 1 plus k. We had it in terms of n, but we can switch these to k's and it's fine. So we had that last time. Or we can just as easily rewrite it in terms of k plus 1. Oh, this is a minus. I'd do that over and over again. Like that, k minus 1. So we can add 1 to all the k's. So now that gives us that, and that gives us k plus 1. So I just took everywhere I put a k, I put a k plus 1. Okay, now I have this assumption with my crooked handwriting. This assumption here. So I can say L times k plus 1 is equal to 1 plus k plus 1 over 2 plus k plus 1. And now it's really just a question of algebraing it through it. Now we know in our goal we want to have this 1 off by itself. Let me switch colors. In our goal we want to have this 1 off by itself, so I'm specifically not going to try to collaborate or combine or collapse that one into the summation, although I certainly could. Instead, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna make a common denominator here. 1 plus, and I'm gonna k squared plus k plus 2k plus 2 over 2. That gives me 1 plus k squared plus 3k plus 2 over 2. And if I factor that, I get 1 plus k plus 2, let me do it the other direction, k plus 1, and then k plus 2 over 2, and I can just as easily write this as k plus 1 plus 1 if I'm really going to be a stickler for matching it perfectly, and that is in fact the goal that I had. So I made my goal, here, I made my goal, so I can QED it. Yay!